Hey, I'm Fernando Ramiro-Manzano, and this is our Optical Lab. The first thing you can see in an Optical Lab is an Optical Table. Here, various optical setups are interconnected. We will discuss them later. Then, on the right, you can see a water installation for cooling high-power equipment. Next, an old spectrometer used for extracting valuable optical elements. This big box provides an uninterruptible power supply for the lab. Then, our bench used for sample preparations, electronic adjustments, as well as a microscope for first inspections. We preserve and repair ancient discrete power electronics for lasers. Here, there's the second optical table. And now let's focus on the storage cells. Here we storage the different samples, as well as different electrical probe tips and cables, always present in physics labs. Here, there's temporal storage of optical elements and different microscope objectives. We have a catalog of optical lenses. As well as several optical filters. There are several cells for old and new equipment. Protection glasses for absorbing different spectral regions, or let's say, color ranges. From time to time, we storage small parts of the setups. Here, there's tools, as well as screw sets. And now, our Lego. A collection of optomechanical pieces such as cage plates, tubes, kinematic mounts, positioners, rotation stages, different posts, post holders, clamps, bases, etc. We have different kinds of mirrors, including focusing mirrors. The optics must be cleaned carefully with the appropriate cleaning tools. This is the setup of optical fiber tools, patches and reels. And now let's focus on the optical table. Here we prepare, condition, measure and acquire various light phenomena. We use different light sources, such as lasers, that can be focused on micro or nanometric samples. In fact, we establish a precise nanometrical control of the samples, objectives, or electrical probes. For a broadband illumination, we can use the supercontinuum source, that is like a white laser. This light can be prepared and conditioned to extract these spectral components, or let's say colors, by using diffraction gratings in the visible, near, and mid-infrared. They are similar to prisms, but in reflection. The gratings are the core of a commercial spectrometer. In any case, and depending on the experiment, the signal is prepared and conditioned accordingly. For example, the light can be polarized, phase-modulated, chopped, its beam profile selected, or even made to interfere with itself. Many times, the commercially available devices do not fulfill our conditions. Thus, we create new ones that fit exactly our requirements. Last but not least, the sample is observed and positioned using different camera systems, and its signals are collected from different angles. This allows us to acquire, for instance, light reflection, transmission, scattering, and emission. And then we arrive at the same point on the table where we started. And now let's take a look to the connected devices to the optical table. Computer screens. Locking amplifier for isolating the desired modulated signal. Light drivers and controllers. oscilloscope for acquiring time domain signals, other light drivers and signal conditioners, one important device, the temperature controller, and behind the ray detector controllers, the computer. Now let's put on or wear all the protections, switch off the lights, and rock and roll! Hope that you enjoy this visit. So, see you.